Would you sit, please? Welcome, everyone. Good morning. Welcome to this sunny Palm Sunday. Welcome to you at home. Just to put your minds at rest, I did test negative yesterday. Yes. So I'm still a bit coldy, as you can hear. My voice is a bit funny, but we'll get through it. Most of the team is out with COVID, unfortunately, so I'm so sorry, youngsters, there is no Sunday school today, because I should have been taken Sunday school, but I'm doing this bit, and Leslie should be preaching, but I'm preaching. So it's, yeah, we're muddling through, so please enjoy the activities that I put out for you. Mums, you might have to help them create their palm branches, but... And don't worry about noise, just relax, it's fine. As usual, all the words that you need will be on the screen. Please join in the words in yellow. We come to prepare for the holiest of weeks. We will journey through praise with joy on our lips. We will travel through betrayal and death, cradling hope deep in our hearts. Jesus leads us through this week, and we will follow, for he is the life we long for. He is the word who sustains us. We wave palm branches in anticipation. We lay our love before him to cushion his walk. Setting aside all power, glory, and might, he comes, modeling humility and obedience for all of us. Hosanna, Hosanna, blessed is the one who brings us the kingdom of God. So we're going to do our action praise. Kids, you might, if you remember this one, if you've been to Messi before, you will know this one. We haven't done it for a little while. It's Jesus, you're my superhero. Do you remember? Anyone remember it? Okay, just watch me follow the actions, okay? Join in as best you can. I'll be a solo act, it's fine. Would you stand, please? I don't know what happened there. We want a full screen video. Come on. Play full screen, please.
Sunshine, he's
So hopefully you all... Not as better as I thought. Excuse me. I'll get my breath back in a minute. Hopefully you've all, I can't think, had a palm cross when you came in. So if you'd like to hold them. This blessing can be heard coming from a long way off. This blessing is making its steady way up the road toward you. This blessing blooms in the throats of women, springs from the hearts of men, and tumbles from the mouths of children. This blessing is stitched into the seams of the cloaks that line the road, etched into the branches that trace the path, echoes in the breathing of the willing colt, the click of the donkey's hoof against the stones. Something is rising beneath this blessing. Something will drown it out. But this blessing cannot be turned back, cannot be made to still its voice, cannot cease to sing its praise of the one who comes along the way it makes. So we say together, God our Saviour, whose Son Jesus Christ entered Jerusalem as Messiah to suffer and to die, let these branches be for us signs of his victory, and grant that we who bear them in his name may ever hail him as our King and follow him in the way that leads to eternal life. Amen. So let's stand to sing Make Way. If you're feeling brave or adventurous, or even if you're the spirit lead, you can obviously wave your branches. Confession. We say together, most merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, We confess that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbours as ourselves. In your mercy, forgive what we have been. Help us to amend what we are and direct what we shall be, that we may do justly, love mercy, and walk humbly with you, our God. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And we affirm our faith together. We believe in God the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named. We believe in God the Son, who lives in our hearts through faith and fills us with his love. We believe in God the Holy Spirit, who strengthens us with power from on high. We believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. We have our readings, please.
Psalm 118:19-24. Open to me the gates of righteousness, that I may enter through them and give thanks to the Lord. This is the gate of the Lord, the righteous shall enter through it. I thank you that you have answered me and become my salvation. The stone that the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone. This is the Lord's doing. It is marvellous in our eyes. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
Luke 19:28-40. Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus' triumphal entry into Jerusalem. After he had said this, he went on ahead, going up to Jerusalem. When he had come near Bethphage and Bethany, at the place called the Mount of Olives, he sent two of his disciples, saying, go into the village ahead of you, and as you enter it, you will find tied there a colt that has never been ridden. Untie it and bring it here. If anyone asks you, why are you untying it? Just say this, the Lord needs it. So those who were sent departed and found it as he had told them. As they were untying the colt, Its owners asked them, why are you untying the colt? They said, the Lord needs it. Then they brought it to Jesus. And after throwing their cloaks on the colt, they set Jesus on it. As he rode along, people kept spreading their cloaks on the road. As he was now approaching the path down to the Mount of Olives, the whole multitude of disciples began to praise God joyfully with a loud voice for all the deeds of power that they had seen in him, saying, blessed is the King who comes in the name of the Lord, peace in heaven and glory in the highest heaven. Some of the Pharisees in the crowd said to him, teacher, order your disciples to stop. He answered, I tell you, if these were silent, the stones would shout out. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
We stand to sing, Praise is Rising. Would you stand, please?
Thank you.
So this is Leslie's sermon, read by me, because Leslie has COVID. Get well soon, Les. I don't know how many of you remember a coronation, looking at your faces, only a few. A few. It was 70 years ago, June the 2nd, 1953. Too long ago for many of us to remember. Fun fact, did you know Buckingham Palace boasts 775 rooms and 78 bathrooms? Fun fact. But many of us do remember the wedding of Princess Diana and Prince Charles. Many of us will remember the wedding of William and Kate Middleton. England was aflutter with excitement. Kate's dress and her wedding ring drew much attention, as did Pippa's bottom. Sorry, Les. Prince Harry was the best man, and the wedding was held at Westminster Abbey. There were two choirs, one orchestra, two fanfare teams that provided the music at the wedding service on April the 29th. During the ceremony at the 1,000-year-old Westminster Abbey, trumpeters from the Central Band of the Royal Air Force played while the happy couple signed the register, making them husband and wife. For the wedding reception, they took over London's exclusive Goring Hotel. The 100-year-old hotel is intimate, luxurious and private, and has its own royal pedigree. During the Queen's coronation, the royal families of Europe stayed at the Goring. Its kitchen was actually the command centre for the chief of Allied forces during World War I. As for the royal coach, well, they had two options there as well. One for rainy weather, the nice glass one built in 1881, or if the sun was, and if the sun was shining, the open roof state landau carriage. No detail is left to chance. Now compare all of that magnificence with Jesus's coronation, if you like, in Jerusalem. Jesus doesn't ride in a royal limo or a glass coach, but on a donkey. The donkey is a humble beast of burden. And as this donkey carries Jesus, Jesus was no doubt feeling extra heavy himself because of the burdens he was carrying as he entered Jerusalem to die on the cross, bearing the weight of the world and all of its sin. Not to mention its hopes and dreams for freedom. This particular donkey is a virgin donkey, never having been ridden before, symbolising the innocence of Jesus, the man who has never sinned. When he entered the city, there were thousands of people waiting to greet him. It must have been quite a sight, all those people lining the streets to see the man they had heard about, but many had never seen until now. This wasn't the first time Jesus had been welcomed by people lining the streets, or the first time he drew such big crowds. He often had thousands who came to hear him preach and teach all through his ministry. So maybe this day, this Palm Sunday as we now call it, wasn't quite as unique as we think. It probably wasn't even the largest or loudest crowd that Jesus had experienced. But there was something different about that day. Something different about the atmosphere. Something different about the actions of the people. They'd cut palm branches and used their cloaks to line his path, something that was reserved for a king or a head of state. Suddenly the crowds were not afraid to publicly proclaim who they believed Jesus to be as they cried out, "Hosanna to the Son of David. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest heaven." But it was one thing to think that about Jesus, or even say it up north in Galilee where no one really took much notice. But it was totally different to say it out loud in Jerusalem. During the Passover feast, in a packed city, Roman soldiers keeping an eye out for the slightest sign of rebel activity against the empire. If word got back to government officials, what these people were saying, that there was a new king in town, it could turn ugly very quickly. It could end in executions. But the crowds didn't care. The cries of the crowd could not be silenced. Hosanna, which means save us, continued to come from the people. But from what did they want Jesus to save them? And for what did they want Jesus to save them? What did they actually want Jesus to do? How many of them looked to Jesus to save them from their problems and the rule of the Roman Empire, foreigners that invaded their land, treating them like second-class citizens and taxing them to the hilt? It makes me wonder, if Jesus decided to make an appearance today in our world, how many people would line the streets and cry out to him, Hosanna, save us. Now, there might be cynics that would say not many, but I'm not so sure. How many people have already been doing that without Jesus making a visible appearance? How many people throughout our world have been calling out to God, save us? I think there have been quite a few, especially now. It's the natural response when tragedy strikes, when sadness overwhelms, when life is hard, when the future seems uncertain, when financial ruin stares us in the face, when we are aware of our limitations, aware of our weaknesses, our mortality, people are quick to cry out, Jesus, save us. But again, I ask, from what are we looking to be saved? And for what are we asking to be saved? Saved from the things that we don't like, that are uncomfortable, that are scary? Save us from those things so that we can have the life that we want, so that we can do what we want. What are we looking for Jesus to do for us? Does Jesus care about the things that we're going through in our life today? Yes, he absolutely does. In fact, God cares a lot, and he invites us to turn to him in bad times. He says in the Psalms, call on me in the day of trouble. I will deliver you, and you will honour me. He's interested in us and wants to help us. Just look at Jesus' life and ministry. It wasn't conducted in secret, away from people. Jesus was interested in people. He was involved in their lives and in their problems. His miracles relieved people's suffering, which allowed them to enjoy life more fully. Yes, Jesus can, and more often than we probably give him credit for, does save us from our problems, take away pain, and gives us strength to endure. But if that's all we're looking for Jesus to do, then like many in that Palm Sunday crowd, we've missed who this man riding into Jerusalem truly is to us. If Jesus is only someone to save us from our problems of this life and make us a bit more comfortable for now, then Jesus isn't much of a saviour at all. He's just whining and dining us through this life, knowing when it comes to an end we're lost forever, separated from him in an eternity in hell. But at least he gave us a good time while it lasted, right? No. Jesus wants so much more for us. Jesus just didn't want for a while. Jesus wants forever. Jesus doesn't want us to be comfortable or to know joy or happiness for a while. He wants us to know it without end. You see, Jesus is not riding into Jerusalem on a donkey because he always wanted to know what it would be like to ride on a donkey. You could go to Blackpool for that. Jesus goes to Jerusalem for you and me. He goes to Jerusalem fully knowing what is waiting for him and what will happen to him over the next week. The hatred, betrayal, desertion, arrest, suffering, crucifixion, death. Jesus goes to Jerusalem to offer his perfect life in the place of imperfect people, us. People who have at times manipulated Jesus to be the saviour we want him to be, instead of the saviour we need him to be. For people like us robbed him of the honour he rightly deserves by doing what we want instead of what he wants. For us, Jesus goes to Jerusalem to sacrifice his life on the cross as the payment for our eternal life with him. Jesus goes to Jerusalem to die so that when our life comes to an end, it will not be the end, but the beginning of perfection, joy, happiness, peace, healing that will have no end. We might be familiar with a glimpse of heaven's glory that Jesus gives us in Revelation 21. God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. There will be no more death, or mourning, or crying, or pain, for the old order of things has passed away. That's what Jesus came to Jerusalem for. That's what Jesus is saving us for. That's what the empty tomb of Easter morning reassures us is waiting for us at the end of this life. A perfect life that has no end. You see, the kingdom of God isn't made up of kings and queens who live in great palaces, eat the finest food, stay in the best hotels, and dress in gold. Those who live in his kingdom do not live a life of ease. It's for those with a servant mentality, the ones who are content to reign from a humble donkey or be hung from a cross. In Jesus' kingdom, he turns it all upside down. The rich and the powerful end up cleaning grates, scrubbing floors, cleaning windows, washing feet, as Jesus did. Yes, this is the king to whom the crowds cried, Hosanna, the servant king, who longs to take us, to change us, to be like him, and to see that his way is the only way. Amen. Let's pray. Thank you for sending your Son and saving the way for our lives to be set free through Jesus' death on the cross. Thank you for what this day stands for, the beginning of Holy Week, the start of the journey towards the power of the cross, the victory of the resurrection, and the rich truth that Jesus truly is our King of Kings. Hosanna. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Amen. We continue in prayer.
Lord, we have come to celebrate your power and to give thanks for your glory. We have come to praise you for Jesus and for his coming to share in our lives. We thank you for his riding into Jerusalem. We praise you for the joy of Palm Sunday. We praise you that Jesus is King of your kingdom. We thank you that he comes on as the Prince of Peace. We pray for the countries in our world that need your peace. We think of the people of Ukraine. Jesus, our Prince of Peace, bring your peace to that country where people are losing their loved ones, their homes, and their freedom. We pray for an end to the atrocities taking place. Lord, be with all those in Ukraine at this time. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray, Lord, for your world, for our world leaders and governments. Give them wisdom, Lord, as they make decisions for the people of their countries. May they be mindful of those who are struggling to make ends meet, or those on low incomes and without jobs. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we pray for your church throughout the world. May we be open to your Holy Spirit and receive the gifts you want us to use for your church. We pray for our Bishop Simon and Jonathan and his family as they settle in their new home in Rochester. We pray for our clergy and lay ministers, especially Trudy, Victor and Leslie in St. Mary's,
and Hannah, our ordinand.
We pray your blessing on their ministry to our congregation and the community in need. May we, your children, be ever mindful of the needs of others here and throughout the world. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus, we pray for the homeless and the hungry and all the aid agencies who help to alleviate the problem. We pray for those who work and volunteer in the food banks, sanctuaries and soup kitchens, and those who use these services. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray, Lord, for the sick in body, mind or spirit, those suffering from anxiety and depression, those in hospices, nursing homes, and those suffering at home. We pray for those who work in the NHS and those who care for people in the community. We pray for those on our WhatsApp prayers and pew sheet. We pray for Granny Anne, Brenda, Kitty, Sinead, Caroline and family, Lorraine, Jean and Brian, Julie Amos, Christine, Laura, Maria and John, Natalia, Sylvia, Hannah, Sean, Liam, Trish, Zena, Mary and Alan, Nicola, Dawn, Ted and Sandra, and in a moment of silence, those known to us personally.
Lord Jesus, I just want to give testimony to you and say that you do indeed answer prayer, Lord. And I want to say thank you for answering my prayer, for having mercy upon me and my friends. Amen.
Amen. We pray for your healing, Lord. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray, Heavenly Father, for those who are bereaved. We ask you to comfort them in their loss. Be with them in their dark moments by your Holy Spirit, and surround them with your love and family and friends to care for them. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, you have called us to be your servants and to care for others in the name of Christ. May we listen to your voice and be open to your will. Accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
That keeps cutting out, that mic, doesn't it? Would you stand for the peace? Once we were far off, but now in union with Christ Jesus, we have been brought near through the shedding of Christ's blood, for he is our peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
We share the peace by giving a wave. Peace be with you all. And we remain standing to sing from Heaven, UK.
Thank you.
Generous God, creator, redeemer, sustainer, at your table we present this money, symbol of the work you have given us to do. Use it, use us, in the service of your world, to the glory of your name. Amen. Would you sit, please? The Lord is here. His Spirit is with us. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give thanks and praise. That's not on, is it? It is indeed right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. For as the time of his passion and resurrection draws near, the whole world is called to acknowledge his hidden majesty. The power of the life-giving cross reveals the judgment that has come upon the world and the triumph of Christ crucified. He is the victim who dies no more, the lamb once slain who lives forever, our advocate in heaven to plead our cause, exalting us there to join with angels and archangels, forever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We praise and bless you, loving Father, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And as we obey his command, send your Holy Spirit, that broken bread and wine outpoured may be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. On the night before he died, he had supper with his friends, and taking bread, he praised you. He broke the bread and gave it to them and said, Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. When supper was ended, he took the cup of wine. Again, he praised you. He gave it to them and said, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. So, Father, we remember all that Jesus did. In him we plead with confidence, his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross, bringing before you the bread of life and the cup of salvation. We proclaim his death and resurrection until he comes in glory. Lord, by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. You are the saviour of the world. Lord of all life, help us to work together for that day when your kingdom comes, and justice and mercy will be seen in all the earth. Look with favour on your people, gather us in your loving arms, and bring us with all the saints to feast at your table in heaven. Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory are yours, O loving Father, for ever and ever. Amen. Believing and trusting in the promises of God, as our Saviour has taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Come to this table, not because you must or you feel obliged to, but because you may. Not because you are strong, but because you are weak. Come not because any goodness of your own gives you the right to come, but because you need mercy and help. Come because you love the Lord and would like to love him more. Come because he loves you and gave himself for you. Come and meet the risen Christ, for we are his body. All are welcome. All who have been baptized and love the Lord are welcome at his table. If it's not your tradition or you're not sure, come for a blessing. Cross your arms and I'll know to give you a blessing. But do come. we say together, Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen.
Did you manage to make some of that here?
Together, the week in which we recall Jesus' suffering and death, we take up our palm crosses as a sign of our journey with him. God, our Saviour, whose Son, Jesus Christ, entered Jerusalem as Messiah to suffer and die, let these palms be for us signs of his victory. May we ever hail him as our King and follow him in the way that leads to eternal life. Hosanna to the Son of David. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Our Lord is on a journey. May we have the grace to follow this Christ and to give him our very lives. For in giving away our lives, we find them, and in dying, we live. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and those you love and pray for this day and always. Amen. Have a good week, everybody. Hope to see you Maundy Thursday, Good Friday, and then again on Easter Sunday. Enjoy the sunshine. Thank you, everyone.